Hi, I'm Nathan Thaler, a product solutions architect for VMware Cloud. Today, I'm going to walk through an early access demo of VMware Cloud Flex Compute. Let's begin by logging the VMware Cloud console and clicking on a new service called VMware Cloud Flex Compute. In inventory, we see a new tab for Cloud Flex Compute. Let's begin by adding a deployment. This will be our first Cloud Flex Compute environment. Let's give our environment a name, then allocate resources to it. These templates are a new concept in VMware Cloud, so let's spend a moment on the screen. Users may choose from a list of predefined resource templates for their environment. The small template we've selected here would allow, for example, 4 VMs each with one vCPU, 2 GB of RAM, and 15 GB of hard drive space. After selecting our first resource template, we need to find our internal network address range. The first network range is a SuperNet, which contains multiple network segments. In this example, I've decided to choose the default network ranges, but rename the first network segment to follow my own naming convention. Finally, we can review our environment details and click Create to build it. Unlike creating an SDC in VMware Cloud and AWS, this process only takes a few minutes, as we do not need to provision dedicated hosts. With our environment instantiated, we can proceed with uploading templates and ISOs to deploy our VMs from. Please note, from the template upload, to VM creation, to VM lifecycle, we are working purely with the VMware Cloud Service Layer, and not with the vSphere UI or API. Neither the backing vCenter nor NSX are directly available to end users. With our ISO and OVF image upload complete, let's create two VMs, beginning with a web server from our Ubuntu ISO image. We'll give it a single vCPU, 1 gig of RAM, and 10 gigs of hard drive space. Please note, in EA, only DHCP network address allocation is available. With our first VM successfully deployed, let's deploy a second VM, an Ubuntu jump host, built from an OVF template. In EA, the guest customization options are limited. Let's power on both VMs and access the virtual console or web server so we can install the guest OS. No user firewall rules are required to access the guest OS console, as we're interacting with vSphere through the VMware Cloud Service Layer. With our web server VM installed, let's log into the console. As you can see, by default, we have internet connectivity. Let's open up the virtual console on our second VM and get its internal IP address. Switching back to our first VM, we can see that also, by default, VMs in the Cloud Flex Compute environment have east-west connectivity to each other. Now that we've demonstrated default outbound internet connectivity and VM-to-VM connectivity, there are two additional network paths to explore, IPsec VPN and internet egress. Let's start with VPN. In EA, the VPN setup must be performed by VMware working with the EA customer. In this demo, we have VPN tunnel set up between our Cloud Flex Compute environment and an AWS VPC containing an EC2 instance. Please note, this VPN connection to AWS does not provide the same AWS service connectivity as with a connected VPC in the VMware Cloud and AWS offering. For the final network path, let's demonstrate how Cloud Flex Compute VM can be reached directly with the internet. Please note, for EA, requesting EIP and establishing firewall rules governing ingress access to the VM are not self-service and must be established by VMware for the customer. In closing, for a bonus item, I'd like to show off the REST API behind Cloud Flex Compute, which powers both the UI and enables customer-driven automation. After getting the authorization token, we can perform operations against our environment, the VM templates, and the VMs themselves. Thank you for watching this demo of Cloud Flex Compute EA. If you'd like to participate in EA, please contact us at vmc_flexcompute_ea@vmware.com.